I mean, Boogie won personality of the year. That's aged like what?
When?
I can't remember when. I think it was before people realized he was a monster.
Who's this?
Oh, Boogie2988. Do you know?
Oh, yeah, I'm aware of him. Like, see, because I'm sort of friendly with him, but I'm also friends with Frank Hassel. I was the internal mediator for like that whole thing when I'm like, Boogie, why did you point a gun at him? You knew that you weren't in danger, Boogie. And Boogie, like, I shouldn't be talking about DMs out loud, but I have to say this because it was so funny. Right, I'm like, Boogie, you know you weren't in danger. You know he wasn't going to actually do anything. Why did you point a gun at him? And Boogie replies with, he said he was going to rape me, Dankula. and then I'm like, do you, in your heart of hearts, truly believe that Frank Hassel was going to come into your house and butt fuck you? And he's like, and he's like, he literally said that that's what he was going to do. And I'm like, but I, honestly, like, I do not condone it, right? I'm strongly against going to someone's house, right? But I will admit that this was funny when he's like, we've got castle doctrine, and then Frank just goes, castle doctrine means I get to come inside and butt fuck you.
I mean, it feels like, and of course, like, you know about Dragonlord because you made like 2 videos on him. It just kind of reminds me of that, right? Where you did the worst possible thing and have just exacerbated this issue.
Oh no, I didn't make any change to it at all. Like this is the thing. I was like, all I did was brought attention to see people that are in like the UK and America and Canada and all that. Like, I brought their attention to Dragonlord. But see in Germany, everyone knows who he is. Like, everybody in Germany knows who Dragonlord is. I mean, like, they have music festivals outside his fucking house and all that. And like, and this is the thing is, right, nothing major has happened in his life like recently, right? There's been still loads of like trolling and people smashing his windows and like doing all that type of shit, right? He's been catfished 6 times. And one of the catfish, he's standing like in a park to like meet the girl, quotes. And instead, a bunch of guys run up and throw jugs of piss on him.
Oh, and,
But like,
that's
the one,
that's the so other mean.
One, because you get basically banned from he's banned from streaming by like the Bavarian State Center for New Media, which in German translates to BLM. but basically BLM banned him from streaming. He ignored it and he kept streaming, and they went, okay, you've kept streaming, here's a fine for 900 euros. He didn't pay it, he kept streaming, and they went, okay, here's another fine for 2,000 euros on top of the 900 euro fine. He ignored that, he kept streaming. And they went, okay, we're at the point now where if you don't stop streaming, the police are going to get involved and you're going to be arrested for, like, not paying the fine. And that was the last I heard about it, but to be fair, that was maybe about 6 months ago, right? But the thing is, like, Dragonlord, he can't even buy a new T-shirt, so how the fuck is he going to afford, like, 2,900 euros to pay this fine? So I think, like, the next big thing that's going to happen is he's going to go to jail. He's going to go to fucking prison, and that'll probably be when I make the third video.
Hooray! German representation, hooray!
Yeah, like, it's fucking mental, but, like, this is the thing is, it's not like Chris Chan, where, like, Chris Chan is at least, like, actually, like, severely autistic and very mentally unwell, where you can sympathize with Chris Chan and just do the whole, he doesn't know any better, like, type thing, right? But whereas Dragonlord doesn't actually have anything wrong with him, he's just a fucking idiot.
Yeah.
that's why you can't really pity him that much, because like, it's the thing is, see if he just stopped replying and stopped like antagonizing these people, if he stopped going outside whenever they come to his house, all of it would die down. But every single time, like, fucking either, like, every single time someone sits outside his house and goes, Rainer, who are Rainer? Like, he comes out right away, like, how am Scheiße, fucking going off his nut. He gives them what they want every single time, and as long as he keeps doing that.
Every time. And yes,
I think
like
that's the reason.
I've got a video of him beating someone with a broom. that's the last one that happened.
Well, I think that's the reason why I mentioned the whole Boogie thing, because it's like the worst thing he could have done was what he did.
Yeah, he did exactly what
giving him a reaction, and plus doing something that was super dangerous, like firing a warning shot.
Well,
like,
but remember, just to cut in on that, yeah. He fired a shot. Wasn't it near a school zone? And when he was like confronted with this, he was like, "Nobody got hit."
As if that, that's the point.
Well, in hindsight, the bullet didn't land on a child, so I guess it's all right.
I think he said, like, if there were any damage, then it would have been reported by now, so there wasn't any. It's like, wow.
I feel like a lot of people forget, which is funny for me to say as an Australian who doesn't own a gun. I find it strange that people forget that bullets are, like, physical objects. That, you know, like, that they do, they come down. Like, they don't just keep going forever.
Thanks to the Old West, there's like 1,000 bullets all flying all over the universe because they just fired them up and off they go.
In the space, tub.
They do that at Serbian weddings as well. I've seen many a wedding get ruined on live leak. Just because I've got Uncle Frank leaned a wee bit too far to the left. Oh. And that's a 5-year-old child gone.
it's the results. But yeah, did any of you guys check out the Monday Matt and Boogie's like big blowout over that thing? It was fucking hilarious.
Was that the one where Monday and Matt actually schooled Boogie?
It was such a bizarre scenario.
They're just like having a contest to see who's the biggest loser.
Monday Matt was trying.
Like,
to
Monday Matt. Because the whole thing with that was Monday Matt was like, oh, I'm just asking questions, you know, like, I'm investigating. Like, Monday, they're both so crap, and it's like having these two, it's like when Earth and whatever the moon was initially crashing into each other, just like this implosion of...
Are you implying that Boogie has a gravitational pull?
What do you think is the low end of the scale of when people say an impossible... meets an immovable object, an unstoppable force? Like, what would be, like, a pathetic force meets a movable object? Like,
the unmeltable ice cream versus the broken hairdryer. Like,
that's pretty good.
Like, the world's most manipulative person versus the most unmanipulatable... I don't even know.
Yeah, it's hard to characterize, you know, because we just haven't come across it
before. What was it the Boogie was shouting? Like, this is my life, this is my life. Like, that was the main thing that he was shouting.
This is my life, this is my life.
It's my life. Oh, apparently my mic.
I was about to bust out some Bon Jovi there. Yeah.
But I just remember it being funny. The whole thing was fucking crazy. And because I didn't know about it before the memes, so I was just seeing all these images of Boogie aiming his gun at a camera, and I was like, what is the concept for this?
At first, I didn't really know what was going on, and people were like, Boogie just fucking fired a shot, like, at Frank Castle. That's what I heard at first, you know, man, and I was like, what? And then they were like, everyone's like, yeah, Frank Castle just went to fucking Boogie's house, and it all kicked off, and I DM'd Frank Castle, and I went, did you just go to Boogie's house, and he just shot at you? And he just wrote back, yeah, lol, what a fucking pussy.
Yeah, lol.
Like, that's the thing is, I think, like, see to anyone that isn't familiar at all with, like, Frank Hassel's content, like, I understand how, okay, you might be a little bit worried about it, but see if you actually, like, watch his content, he actually has, like, strict rules, like, where he doesn't, like, lay a hand on a person, he doesn't touch them at all. Like, there's even videos he has where people are, like, fucking punching him in the head and shit, and, like, pinning him down against fences, and he doesn't retaliate at all.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, he's got strict rules about that shit.
I think that was the asking question thing that Monday Matt got in trouble for. He was like, was it performance? Was it all just to, you know, rustle up some views and caused a major blow, a battle of the titans, if you will. The Matt versus the Boogie.
Do you want to know how it all started? It all started because someone, like, said Boogie was opening magic cards on a stream, and someone said someone sent him like a photo. Shut up, I do that. someone sent him like a super chat on stream, like mentioning Frank Hassel and all that, man. And like, what was it? I can't even remember how it got mentioned, but like Boogie said something like, oh, Frank Hassel, that's a weird name. And Frank heard about him. Frank came into the fucking stream chat and was going, I'm going to find you, I'm going to hunt you down, I'm going to citify and bimbofy you, and all.
Oh my god.
And he's like, there was one where it was, I think it was all caps, just, I am going to fuck your arse. And then
what a strange person.
Boogie started like freaking out on stream, and there's the more and more Boogie spoke, the worse and worse he was making it for himself.
That's Boogie. He's just, the more he talks, the worse it gets.
Yeah. Oh yeah, like that time he was talking about the Holocaust, where he pure says, "Oh well."
Oh damn.
This one was wonderful. Well, the Nazi scientists were actually doing a lot of experiments on Jews and the camps and stuff like that. And as a result of those experiments, we actually greatly advanced a medical knowledge, which is where Boogie should have stopped talking.
Yeah, that was right. Point is right.
That statement, although true, not nice. It's true, like, but you know, it's not a nice thing. But
then we don't talk about that.
Yeah, but then Boogie decided to end it by saying, "So in a way, the Holocaust was kind of a good thing."
Oh, no.
Boogie, no!
No, don't say that. Boogie, you can't stop. Talk about the Holocaust like that, Boogie. It's the big bad.
That's still not even his best quote. It's easily the rape one. What does he say? At least
Nazis and rapists stand for something.
At least Nazis and rapists believe in something. It's like, what do rapists believe in?
Yeah, imagine comparing like people shit talking you to like and saying that Nazis and rapists will be better. Imagine that shit.
He's just I don't know what it is. I don't know what it is. Like I still like Boogie, and I other people in the YouTube community don't feel the same way, but I still have like an element of like pity for him, but I think he's probably in the same situation as Dragonlord, where he doesn't realize that the way he responds to these things is encouraging it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, for sure. Well, yeah, that's the constant question, right? Like, is he doing it on purpose, Boogie? Is he just trying to drum up some shit, or is he just stupid, or what's going on there? And that's what people wonder.
But as it turns out, if you ask that question, Boogie will come on your stream and yell about how you're a terrible person.
Which, to be honest, doesn't help. Does it? It's like, how fucking dare you ask that question? You're like, you're kind of supporting one side of the argument there with this. Just saying. And then, of course, I was just going to say, like, one last one. The, was it $3 is a lot for a person of color? Or something
oh
like
my
that?
God. Oh, yeah.
He did not say that.
He did.
Yeah. Oh,
that reminds me of that fucking poster that got hung up in schools like around England, and they all got immediately taken down because they said everyone should be accepted, everyone should be equal. It doesn't matter if you're black, brown, or normal.
Well, the sentiment was there.
No, what the fuck?
It's off the counts, guys.
Do you not know about that that quote, by the way?
I've never heard of that.
The dollar
it was
one.
On stream. He
wait, can
he,
we
he
can we show them it? Can we show them it? It's really funny.
Oh, I know about the Boogie thing, not the poster thing.
No, well, I was gonna say, if Dank hasn't seen the Boogie one, that shit's fucking hilarious.
Yeah, I think I've damn it.
Must find. Also, there's 5 people in Watch Together. If anybody else hasn't jumped in, go right ahead. You've used Watch Together before, right, Dank? You know what it does?
I have. Yeah, we use it to watch porn.
Watch.
I'm kidding. No, we don't.
Use it. Porn's so much better with friends, videos. Though.
No, it is actually. When I was in America, like me and a bunch of like subscribers on my channel, I actually watched Footaboo together.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, Footaboo, I don't know how that didn't get drowned in Emmys.
I think I found it. Hold on. Are we all in the Watch Together?
I am.
Yeah, looks like 6 are here.
Alright.
I'm here.
Time for excitement.
Oh.
Yo.
It's
Sprogon, I'm glad to hear you're still black. And thank you too much for support, man. That's a lot of money, I guess, for a person of color. Or
what the fuck?
I don't know.
You know how he instantly says that, and he's like, oh, fuck.
He knows what he's done. He's whoa.
Regret. He regrets it immediately. Like,
that was like the PewDiePie realization.
Yeah,
it came from there, like, you know, the infamous incident on the bridge where the instant PewDiePie says it, he just goes, "Oh fuck, oh Jesus!"
You do the full circle. You're like, in aid of being not racist, you come all the way back to racist. You're like, oh shit. Yeah, I'll just roll it back.
Is that the little psychopath gun he's holding up?
Well, yeah. So I was gonna say,
he's representing your show. How do you feel about that?
I'll roll it back. Oh, no. If we play it again, right? It's just funny. Look at how he tries to distract his audience from what he just said immediately. It's really funny.
Go for you.
I'm a black person.
Sprogon, I'm glad to hear you're still black. And thanks for 2 months of support, man. That's a lot of money, I guess, for a person of color, or is it not? I don't know.
Oh,
I have a gun.
No.
It's also a USB drive.
he just points it at himself. Dominator, lethal mode.
Yeah, what's his psycho level or whatever it is?
1488, apparently.
2988,
No, it's so dumb. He could have stopped that. Thank you for subscribing for 2 months. He could have stopped right there.
Yeah,
right?
He could have.
It's just a weird thing to say in general.
What
like,
kind
if
of black
subscribes
person
to you,
calls
you just
say
thank
dumb.
You and just like, oh, that's a lot of money for you. Like, okay.
You black person.
So a guy walks up to him and goes, hey, I got a job. And he's like, yeah, not bad for a black guy.
I'm really proud of, you know, you in particular for doing that.
You are not
you
normal
did it,
person.
Person of color.
Oh, in fairness, apparently the following clip is the one we were just talking about, so they can see it in context.
I don't know if that'll you, Twitch. So bring it. But I want you to know... I think you are the lowest of the low. I think you are the worst of the worst. I think that there are fucking rapists and Nazis out there who, even though they are rapists and fucking Nazis, they are more redeemable than you because at least they're doing something they fucking believe in.
I believe in rape. So I'm gonna go out and just rape.
You get shot by the cops. At least I died. I believed in.
I died streaming World of Warcraft.
I love the quote. Because
doing something I believe in.
I think he thinks it's like an ode, and it's just so funny. Like, why would you say this?
Can you imagine like a rapist being in like his Twitch chat going, oh, thank you, Boogie. Thank you for representing us.
Yeah,
like,
you just every understand. Chat's like, yeah. Fuck you, loser trolls.
Every Boogie insult is like Wile E. Coyote with one of his contraptions that he thinks is really clever, but it ends up backfiring and like exploding himself.
He pushes the boulder off the cliff to hit the person. It swings all the way around and back into his head. It's just like, oh.
Well, yeah, because what happened with that first clip was like, when Wile E goes off the cliff and he looks down, as soon as he looks.
What a strange tangent. Love you, Boogie. You're coming out with these quotes. It's just wonderful.